Morning, everybody. Hope you're well. Another sort of grey, groggy day down here. Monday morning, second mug of coffee. Hope you're all well. Hope your weekend was nice. We didn't do a morning coffee. What did we do instead? Sarah's been working all weekend towards the deadline of her book. Working so hard, actually, that she might have finished everything a couple of days early. So we've got a big day of rehearsal today and tomorrow, and then we're actually in the studio on Wednesday. But we'll only decide whether or not we can... We'll only discover whether or not we can actually record on Wednesday and whether the studio problem is fixed on Wednesday morning. Which is interesting. But we'll just have to see how it goes. I need to try and work out if there's a backup for if we can't record on Wednesday, because it feels like we then would have rehearsed loads and then stopped doing the videos for nothing, which would be a bit of a pain. But we've got to just hope it happens. We've got our 20 songs sorted, 10 originals, 10 covers. Lots of cello, lots of harmonies, lots of dual guitars. It's going to be fun. I'm trying to think of the last thing I did. I think I did 1992. Was it on Friday? On Friday. Let's read some comments. Mark says, given so much has changed, how about everything will change? Mark, good idea. Anya says, such a romantic song, 1992. Ian says, cheers, Tom, absolutely loving the new guitar. Oh yes, Ian's new guitar, his 12-string. Plays like a total dream. It might even inspire me to write a song for the first time in 20 years. Fantastic. How about trying in the new batch of mugs? How about tying in the new batch of mugs to the upcoming 100th episode of Morning Coffee? Does 100th anniversary have a colour associated with it, like ruby for 40th or gold for 50th? If not, I'm sure with the fine art sensibilities between you and Sarah, you'll come up with a cracking colour choice. Ian, I've actually... new mugs are on the way, and they are special. Let me just quickly remind myself to email warehouse about new mugs. And what else was I going to do? These videos have now just become me leaving reminders for myself. I've already forgotten. Oh, yes. I need to chat to Tom about backup recording plan. See, this is my life, just like chaotic iCal. Julie says, hi Tom, thanks for taking the time to chat to us. Your schedule sounds incredibly busy. Sarah's artwork is amazing. How thrilling it must be to have seen her Natural History Museum poster on the tube. Yes, my dear, you have arrived. Enjoyed hearing 1992 with great harmonica just add something to the song. Very Dylan-esque. Is that a word? It is a word, Julie. Definitely. Let me just check. I've got all those comments. Yes. Michelle says, your voice is so soothing. Thanks, Michelle. Is that the right video, actually? Oh, yeah, it is. How about Talking Through For You from New House? I love that song, Joe. This is from Joe Horton. No one really talks about that song. I don't think anyone... I remember we did a take of it, and I said to Ian, the engineer, well, the producer, I said, Ian, I like that take. And he turned around and he said, it's your funeral. So I think the take that we did, he didn't think was very good, but I still like that song. If you haven't heard it, it's called For You from New House. Ryan says, can you remind me of the tuning to Everyone Needs a Home? Dad Fad, D-A-D, F-sharp, A-D. Let's see what else we've got here. People talking about the vinyl that I was listening to at the weekend. Marble vinyl is everywhere at the moment, right? Almost every record that I've bought recently has been coloured vinyl. Any vinyl geeks out there? I thought that coloured vinyl sounded worse than black vinyl. Is that true? Does coloured vinyl sound worse? Someone says, that's right, coloured vinyl always sounds worse. They're not pressed with the same well-formulated vinyl that your plant is used to working with. Is colour worse than black vinyl? Only white vinyl should sound worse. The white substance used to dye the record, can cause random pops. Rumour has it that it's a kind of chalk. Other vinyl, coloured or clear, can be dead quiet, so a coloured vinyl record with no black in it might actually sound better out of the wrapper than a black one. Oh, right. Is picture vinyl bad? Yes. Yeah, any vinyl geeks out there, have you got any opinions on whether black vinyl and coloured vinyl sound different? Are they different materials? I think they are. Callum says, thank you for the insight on 1992, Tom. Was waiting for that one. And Michael says, your weather report is the only weather report I watch. Well, Michael, it is gloomy as AF out there, as AF. So I thought I'd play a song, technically the last ever Tom Williams and the Boat song released? Because it's the last song on the last album. I definitely was thinking about that when I wrote this one, but I also think it's, you know, we hadn't actually discussed as a band that we'd be stopping, but I think that was the vibe. You know, we'd done 3 albums in 4 years, which is pretty good. And we did, you know, before that we did about 5 EPs in 2 years from sort of 2007 to 2009. Yeah, 2009, 2010. And this is also definitely a transition from, I think, Tom Williams and the Boat stuff into the new guitar, new house stuff. There's a lot of Dylan imagery in here. A lot of Hard Rain's Gonna Fall type imagery. It's a bit of a stream of consciousness song again, so it'll be interesting for me to play it and see what I think of the lyrics and see if I can pick anything out from that time. Strangely, not that strangely, my dad loves this song. And he's been trying to learn it on guitar recently. And there's a little tricky sort of A7 turnaround thing at the beginning, which he finds tricky. Because you have to flatten your first finger to play it. Actually, you don't have to, but you have to squish all your fingers in. And he plays a small guitar. He plays a baby Taylor. Anyway, let's try this. So this is for Mark, the spreadsheet and pie chart king. Mark, thank you so much for everything you do. I think... that rehearsing, if you hadn't clipped up all the songs and put them into folders for me, I think rehearsing this last week would have been an absolute nightmare trying to find all the songs and what we did on everything. So thank you so much, Mark. So this is for you. This is Everything Will Change. So don't be afraid, 'cause everything will change. Nothing will be the same, 'cause everything will change now, 'cause everything will change now. And you say you're scared of that black branch bleeding. You spend your daytime pleading with the sky, and you think that you'll be lonely, but you only have yourself and only. And it's been that way since 1985. So don't be afraid, 'cause everything will change, and nothing will be the same, 'cause everything will change now, 'cause everything will change now. And it's been 2 weeks now of you calling me up at midnight, complaining of 4 horsemen at your door. And I've told you twice, baby, it's not just the moon and the stars conspiring and lying in a cold black winter sky that you can't control. So don't be afraid, 'cause everything will change. Nothing will be the same, 'cause everything will change. Everything will change now. So don't be afraid, 'cause everything will change. Nothing will be the same, 'cause everything will change. Yeah, so that was, I think in hindsight, I was just talking to myself. You say you're scared of that black branch bleeding. I feel like that's hard rain's gonna fall imagery, isn't it? You spend your daytime pleading with the sky. You think that you'll be lonely and you only have yourself and only, but it's been that way since 1985. I was born in 1986. I think I only said 85 because it rhymes with sky. Five, sky, half rhyme. I think this is me, like, thinking about not having a band. I'm not sure whether I was consciously thinking about it, but you think that you'll be lonely, but you only have yourself and only, and it's been that way since 1985. I think I'm talking to myself. This is like armchair self-psychology here. It's been 3 weeks now of you calling me up at midnight, complaining of four horsemen at your door. End of the world, right? And I've told you twice, baby, it's not just the moon and the stars conspiring and lying in a cold black winter sky that you can't control. Yeah, I think I'm like self-philosophizing. That's definitely what it is. I remember recording this. Normally when the way we recorded that album was live in the room with the band, but I was maybe playing electric. And then I would redo my vocal, because if we did like 20 takes in a row of a song, by the time we get the take on take 17, my voice would be shot, so you redo the vocal. But on this one, I was gonna play acoustic, and we didn't wanna if I was gonna play acoustic in the room, because it would be so loud, I'd have to plug my acoustic in, and then that would sound worse than if you just put a microphone in front of the guitar, which you couldn't do in the noisy room. So I was in the control room, the room with the mixing desk, in this tiny little studio in London, and I was looking through the glass at the band. And I think this one is cut completely live. And it's got such a lovely feel to it. The drums sound fantastic. David's playing on this is amazing. I think the whole band are playing incredibly on this, at the end of this album. It's at the end of the Easy Fantastic album. And the band sound relaxed, and the songwriting is quite relaxed. It's not worried, you know, it's not eager to please this song. It's kind of, it's a lot of stops and starts, but playing it acoustically, it doesn't seem to make as much sense as I remember it doing on the recording. But, you know, great playing by Chris and Anna and Josh and David and Ian recorded it beautifully. And it's kind of the perfect sound for that, his studio as well, because it's quite a dead sound and it's quite a dead room, and all the playing is just really tasteful, and we sound grown up. you know, if you compare that to sort of track one on the first Boat album, which was 24, which was like rushy and youthful and exciting and a bit mad, schizophrenic almost in the way we sort of cut between all different kinds of songs. This feels mature. I'm not saying it's better or worse, but it sounds like we've been in a band together for 5 years, definitely. But if you haven't heard it already, definitely check out the Easy Fantastic album. There's signed vinyl in my online store. It's the final track on the album. Artwork by Sarah. Sarah did the artwork on that album. She also did the artwork for Teenage Blood, and she also did the artwork... Maybe that's it, actually. New Guitar was done by Tom Brooks. All Change was done by Dick Hogg. What Did You Want to Be was also done by Tom Brooks. So, yeah. But check it out if you haven't already. Please do let me know any other songs that I haven't played yet. I'd love to do For You as well. But we're in the studio on Wednesday, so you might get a kind of a studio-y update then, and on Friday as well. Fingers crossed we'll do some recording. Cross all your digits for us, please. I hope it's going to happen. And yeah, we need to get back to practicing. I've got 20 songs to record. What could possibly go wrong? Anyway, have a lovely day, everybody, and I'll see you soon, I'm sure.